Welcome back, guys. We're continuing this Confederate campaign and we're going into Gaines Mill next. So it's a bit of a weird mission where I think only half of your troops actually turn up on time. The other half turn up later on in the battle. And so this is from what I can remember anyway. I haven't tested it, so I might have got it wrong. But basically your first two divisions turn up and then your third and fourth in each corps turn up dead late. So what I've done is put all the best units in the 1st and 2nd Division and then filled out the 3rd and 4th with a load of crap units. Now the reason I've done this is because it's not technically your 1st and 2nd Division turn up and the 3rd and 4th don't. It's half of your divisions turn up, or half of your brigades. So if you didn't have anything in these, only your 1st Division would turn up and your 2nd Division would be late. So to get all of your decent troops in straight away, you've got to fill out the rest of the corps with other units, basically crap units that are not going to show up to the battle. So we've just used cannons to do this. We had a load of spare cannons that weren't doing anything, so we didn't have to actually buy any weapons. And then we had a few spare Springfields that weren't doing anything. And I've been a bit risky and put some Fayettevilles and Harper's Ferries in there as well. But that wasn't entirely necessary. Okay. So we have actually got 9,200 men left over that we could have tried to fit in if we sold some of these other weapons that we weren't using. You can sell these, obviously buy other decent weapons that you want to use to fill out some of the remaining troops. But until your economy's at number 10, your sale price is terrible. So there's no point in selling stuff until you get 10 economy. Unless you really, really need to. It looks like we've actually got two sniper rifles in here that we can stick on here. And then just make a quick save. And then off we go. Right, so we need to take this objective and one of these two. But if you bring all of your troops around here, they'll just retreat all of their troops to here, so it's actually better to not do that. Well, I think anyway. So we're going to let the right flank deal with that problem. Actually got 10 too many brigades in here. So I think I've actually built the wrong in a minute. Right, so 10 of these need to go over to this core. I've built too many units. That's funny. Because I can only actually fit 6 into this core. So 10 of these need to come across and then I'll just get rid of 4. So 1, 2, 3. So I can get rid of 1. Two. Three. Yeah, I may as well get rid of this one as well. 4. I can put them Springfields that we've saved. Well, I'll work that out in a minute, actually. So 10 of these units need to come across. So we need 1 junk and 1 proper unit. I mean, Fayettevilles definitely aren't junk, but 1, 1, 2, 2, 3, 3, 4, 4, 5, 5. Well, I don't know if these actually need to be in the second division or not. I highly doubt it. But let's just move them across just in case. And then in this division, these are the ones that are going to be coming in. Don't really want the Fayetteville coming in. So I've got two Palmettos that aren't really going to get used, which is not a big deal. Okay. So now we are good to go. Right then, off we go. Technically, I can take 5 units in this fourth court, but it's not really necessary at all, to be honest. If I had higher army organisation to get 24 brigades, I could have put 4 brigades in to get two more show up, but it's not a big deal, I don't think. Interesting. We've got the 3rd and the 4th. Oh no, sorry. Yeah. I'm looking at the wrong thing, because the battle hasn't started yet. Right then, so these are our main units. With these, I think I'm going to set them up over here, ready for flanking. With the second lot that come in, I'm going to set them up across here. And then with the flanking force that come in, I'm going to come down, take the main objective over here, and then flank up across here. And then hopefully I'll be able to fully surround them. That's the plan anyway. Whether it'll work or not, I don't know. So 10... Let's just quickly pause it. I want the sniper rifle all the way down here. Really? So these. Right. Yeah. They might be able to shoot me if I come that close. So I might have to go to here and then cross the river. That's probably the best way to do it. Yeah, let's do that. Now they might actually have some skirmishers dotted around. So I might use my general just to see if anything shows its face. Unsurprisingly, skirmishers, and they're going to be attacking the cannons. It's rather annoying. Some more skirmishers here, but I'll see if I can drag these in front of where the infantry are going. Fire! Oops. Looks like I, well, I may as well use him now. I accidentally brought an infantry division with me. So I don't particularly want to be chasing this skirmish unit all over the shop. But if I can get him dealt with, then it'll be worth it. Now there is a vantage point up here. But there's a high chance I'm going to get spotted doing this. But I just want to see if I can see where the enemy are. Should probably turn the speed down. I don't know if trying to shoot is a good idea. Nope, clearly not. Well, that's not good. For some reason, they can still see him. Oh, is it because they've got the vantage point now? That's what I wanted, to be able to see them cannon. It's definitely annoying that they can still see me. Taking unnecessary sniper casualties here. That's unfortunate, they can see how it's. There we go. Can't see him now. He's almost taken a cannon loss. Yeah, these snipers are having a terrible time. We've lost 54 snipers. That's awful. Dealt with the skirmishers, so that's one job. Tempted to try and go in and deal with some of these cannons, but I know I'm going to get hurt in the process. There's far too many infantry there. Might just bring them over to this objective. Maybe use them later on. Maybe use them to take out a unit like this. going to use them to take out some cavalry. Well, he's in a precarious position. Retreating that way. To get them out of there, they're about to get in a lot of pain. Damn it, I didn't think they'd be able to hit me. Some cavalry dealt with. Snipers have had a terrible time in this battle. 70 losses, man. don't know where them skirmishers got to. There's a chance I killed them, but I doubt it. Unfortunately, I couldn't quite finish the encirclement, didn't have enough troops. But we've dealt a significant amount of damage. another capture. I mean, we're not far off an encirclement, but in this marsh it's just so difficult to traverse. That'll do. Wasn't quite perfect, lost a few snipers, wasn't happy about that, but overall we did 12, 13, 14, 15, almost 18,000 casualties to just over 3. So 3 to 18, almost a 6 to 1. Didn't get anyone killed this time, that's rare. Cavalry did the majority of the work, as expected. And we captured quite a few Harper's Ferries, some supplies. So we got about 8,000 supplies, some Harper's Ferries. Can't complain. That will do. So yeah, that was Gaines Mill. I think we'll call it an end to this episode. And then on the next one, we'll be going into Malvern Hill, which is, I find, quite difficult for the Confederates, because they have a lot of cannons. A lot of cannons. So yeah, it'll be interesting to see how we get on there. So cheers for watching, take care, and I'll see you soon.